Hi, my name is Peter Ramsey. I am one of the directors on Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse. Before that, I directed a movie called Rise of the Guardians for DreamWorks Animation, and I've been in the movie business for a long time doing both live action and animation. I think I first found out filmmaking was my passion probably pretty early on before I ever realized I could do it as a career. I just did it as a hobby, Super 8 cameras, a little, early video cameras way back in the day. And it wasn't until probably my early 20s that I realized I could make a living in the business and sort of start to move forward actually being a filmmaker. Working on Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse was a real challenge. I got to work with a lot of incredibly talented people. Miles, everybody who worked on the movie, of course, myself included, fell in love with Miles and with his family and with the idea of presenting them in a way that was gonna be very specific, as authentic as we could make it, and as emotionally real as possible. And that, that meant taking a lot of things about his environment, his personality, the way he related with his father, his mother, and his uncle, getting into the details of all of that stuff to just try to make it as unique and real as possible, because we knew we had to get the audience to fall in love with Miles, to really invest in his story emotionally, if they were ever gonna go through this crazy journey of the Spider-Verse and meeting Peter Parker and all these other characters. You had to have something to anchor yourself to, and you had to want to root for Miles and want him to succeed.
Spider-Man.
It's huge. I mean, you never think of yourself as being a pioneer or making history or anything like that. You're just trying to do a good job, at least me. But it's one of those things that you hope other people coming after you can look at it and go, yeah, it can be done. It's possible. That dude did it. I'm pretty sure I can do it. And there's also so many people, before me that contributed to making a space in the industry in the first place for somebody like me. So it's, I kind of think of it as being a person who was just like kind of lucky enough and prepared enough to be in the right place when the lightning struck. I can't think of another time in my life when it seemed so possible and so active, so dynamic. There's stuff seems like it's really moving, and the power that Black women are just starting to have now in the industry just shows, how obvious it is that everybody should have that voice. I mean, you got like from somebody like Shonda Rhimes to Ava DuVernay, who's like the greatest, making all these incredible strides, and all these. They're empowering so many more people. There's like production companies springing up all over the place, actresses taking power. I think it's beautiful, and it's gonna affect the entire industry for everybody in ways that I don't think anybody even realizes yet. The ripple effects of giving some people a voice that haven't had a voice, and the new kinds of stories that come out, those are just gonna energize all the old stories that come out as well. I think everybody benefits when something happens in the arts or the creative world that is new and exciting. I think it has a way of reinvigorating it, everything. So I think there's gonna be a lot of unexpected new stuff that come from this.
To our audience, thank you so much. We love you, and we want you all to know we see you, you're powerful. This world needs you, okay? This world needs you. So please, we're all counting on you. Thank you.